Hi, I'm Leslie McVane, and welcome to another CTN member highlight. Tonight we're at Space Gallery for the local Love Muscle Film Festival. It's the third annual Valentine's Day Film Festival, and it's a little different this year. Usually the theme is love. They've opened it up and have had many submissions. People are streaming in here getting ready to watch the festival. I think there are 8 films tonight, and we're going to be talking with some of the people who are here, some of the people who organized it. Well, I'm with Jake Oxenherd. Hi, Jake.
Hello, how are you?
A new member of the CTN board, actually.
I am, indeed. Yep.
Welcome.
About 3 weeks ago, a month ago, yep.
Right.
Yep.
Well, you're one of the organizers of this film festival, and have you been here all 3 years organizing?
I have, yeah. I've done all 3 years. Jake Holtz, who's one of the owners, had the original idea for it, but I've pretty much taken the lead of it from the start and put it all together all 3 years.
And how has it grown?
Well, we've got a lot more people every year. The first year we were at Geno's. We had a couple bands play after. Only about maybe 60 people showed up, which we were happy with. I mean, that was a great crowd for what it was for the first year. Last year we did it at the upstairs of the Empire Dine and Dance and completely sold out the place. And I remember the owner coming up to me afterwards just like ecstatic at how many, because it was a Sunday night. They usually don't even open up on Sunday nights, and they were just, you know, blown away by how many people came and everything like that. And then this year it's, you know, we're still 45 minutes from showtime and it's a lot of people, so it's looking good.
Well, I've grabbed one of the filmmakers. Hi, Dan Gorham. What is the theme of your piece tonight? Now, don't give it away. Don't tell us the whole story.
The Butler did it. No,
oh shucks.
Yeah, it's about a young stand-up comic who's deathly afraid of speaking in public, but he's naturally very funny, and just his struggle to sort of get up there, and then what happens when he does. And
do you have a group of filmmakers you work with, you get together with, we talk about issues and getting your work out there?
Right. Yeah, we sort of have like a core like 3 or 4 people, and then there's the screenwriting friends too, and we all talk about different sects of groups basically. But yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Well, I have another filmmaker with me, David Rickers. Hi, David.
Thank you very much. Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing great. Now, you're originally from Union, Maine.
Yes, Union, Maine. I went to high school there, and then I went down to Portland, in South Portland here, at Southern Maine Community College to get my film degree, and it worked out really well.
So you've got a film in the program tonight. What's the name of your film?
Yes, my film is called Power of Music, and it takes place in small town, Portland, almost, about the main character Trevor, and he gets some substantial emotional trauma happens to him, and he can't find his passion anymore. And through a vision, or like almost like maybe like not a spirit animal, but like a spirit vision, he finds his passion again, and he realizes something about the entire universe.
I've got another filmmaker with me, Sean Martin. Hi, Sean.
Hi, how's it going?
You're originally from South Portland.
Yep. From South Portland, Maine, yep.
And when did you start doing film, in high school?
Honestly, I mean, through most of my life, I've been working on films, either acting in them, but it was really when I was 13 when I really started making my own films, editing them, and started doing school projects, and I have not stopped since, so.
You have a real passion.
I couldn't live without this medium. It's amazing.
What's the name of your film that we're going to see tonight?
Mine's called A Handful of Romance. It's a sock puppet. It's a sock puppet film, basically.
Sounds great.
Yeah.
Well, thanks. I know it's getting busy, and you probably have hands to shake.
Yep.
So thank you for taking the time to talk.
Thank you.
With us. Well, I found 2 filmmakers, and our first woman, Anna
Gravel.
Raynan Brown.
Raynan Brown. And you co-wrote, co-produced, co-everything this film. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, I produced and came up with an idea when I was on tour this summer. So it's about the talk that sometimes happens in a relationship that nobody wants to talk about. And then Raynan helped to flesh out the text, and he also directed it.
Sort of building up the courage to tell your spouse a secret or something, you know, to bring that relationship to the next level.
Or not, right. Here we are with another filmmaker, David Wallace. Hi, David.
Hi.
From Brunswick.
Yes.
Right. Now, tell me how long you've been doing film.
I've been doing it about 11 years.
So now you make your own film.
Yes. We just have a lot of fun getting our friends together and putting together a team.
Do you write your shows?
Yes. Well, we wrote the last one last year's, but this year's it was mostly improv.
What's the name of your film?
It's called Formsby Investigates.
Ooh, it sounds exciting.
Well, I hope you'll find it exciting.
The local Love Muscle Valentine's Day Film Festival was started. We have two sponsors this year that helped us out putting things together. One is CTN Channel 5, which is practically right next door. The other sponsor was Peloton Labs, up the street.
As for CTN, they have joined us as a media sponsor, meaning that everything shown here tonight is also going to be online and be shown on Channel 5, which I think is, for all you filmmakers, is a really, really great opportunity. A lot of people don't know a tremendous amount about CTN. I think it's definitely worth checking out. You've obviously got a forum to show your work. There's memberships are $20 a year. You can rent equipment. You've got a big studio inside. If you've never been in there, go in and look at it. There's a green screen. It offers a lot of resources for filmmakers, and I think it's worth checking out.
Well, this is getting really noisy and exciting here. More and more people are coming in all the time, and it's getting so full. I'm going to go in and try to get a seat so I can watch it too. And we hope to bring you their films after the film festival on Community Television Network.